Dear students, welcome to the new lecture in quantum chemistry. In our last lecture, we had seen about the three-dimensional box. In that, we had derived the equation for three-dimensional box. The wave function equation, we had derived it from using Schrodinger's wave equation. In that, we had seen about the equation psi equals in terms of the three dimensions along the x, y, and z axis as a, b, c. We have derived that equation. Now, in today's lecture, we will go for the energy calculations of the three particle in a three-dimensional box and how we can represent it in a graphical manner. We will look into the degeneracy properties of the energy levels and how we can determine that level of degeneracy in the energy levels. That we will take up in this particular lecture.
Psi is equal to under root 2 into 2 into 2 is 8, and denominator will be a, b, c. So now we have to see and derive the psi or the wave function that is under root of 8 upon a, b, c, where a, b, and c are the three distances from origin of the box on x, y, and z axis respectively, into sine of n1 pi x upon a, sine of n2 pi x upon b, n2 pi y upon b, and sine of n3 pi z upon c. Now from this we can have the energy of the total wave function or the energy of the particle which is present inside the box. Now for that purpose, what we can say is that we had derived, we had substituted one, that is k square we had substituted. And similarly, we had also said that here we had said this k1 square, k2 square, and k3 square as k1 square plus k2 square plus k3 square equals k square, which is equal to 8 pi square me upon h square. Using this relationship, we can derive the energy of the particle present in the or represented by this three-dimensional box. That is present inside the box, we can find out the total energy of that particular particle. So for this energy, we have k1 square plus k2 square plus k3 square equals k square, which is equal to 8 pi square me upon h square. Now this k1 square, we know that it is n1 pi upon a. K1 is n1 pi upon a. K2 is n2 pi upon b. And k3 is n3 pi upon c. So if we substitute those values here, we will get n1 square pi square upon a square plus n2 square pi square upon b square plus n3 square pi square upon c square equals 8 pi square me upon h square. If we take pi square common over here, we will get n1 square upon a square plus n2 square upon b square plus n3 square upon c square equals 8 pi square me upon h square. This pi square and this pi square gets cancelled. And if we transfer this 8 m upon h square over the other side, we will get p is equal to h square upon 8 m into n1 square upon a square plus n2 square upon b square plus n3 square upon c square. If we have a cubical box instead of a rectangular box, if we can have a cubical box, then for that particular box, we will have for cubical box, a is equal to b is equal to c. So we can get E is equal to h square upon 8m a square, where a, B and C are all equal, and let that be equal to A, then this all will be same. So denominator of all of them same means numerators we can add it together. So denominator will be coming over here, and we will have here as n1 square plus n2 square plus n3 square. So this will be giving us different states of energy, or the energy of the particle in different states. Now for ground state, we can have that is the minimum energy we can have for ground state. N1 equals N2 equals N3, that is having minimum value as 1. So for that purpose, what we will have is E will be equal to, or we call it as E111. First one will be N1, second N2, and third is N3. So it will be energy E111 will be equal to H square upon 8ma square into 1 plus 1, that is 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square equals 3h square upon 8ma square. If you remember, particle in one dimensional box, we had E1 is equal to h square upon 8ma square. Here we are getting it as 3h square upon 8ma square. So this is 3 times higher than that of a one dimensional box. The minimum energy or the ground state energy is 3 times higher than the ground state energy of a one dimensional box, particle in a one dimensional box. So here this can be represented as a zero point energy for a particle in a three dimensional box. Zero point energy for a particle in a three dimensional box. Similarly, higher energies we can obtain it from here. The numbers N1, N2, and N3 are called as quantum numbers. Are called as quantum numbers. For a two-dimensional box, there will be two quantum numbers, N1 and N2 will be there. For a one-dimensional box, we had only N1, so we had represented it as just N. Three-dimensional box, N1, N2, and N3 are in here. Aapke syllabus mein two-dimensional box bhi hai, one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and three-dimensional. Two-dimensional box mein just aapko kya karna hai, ki jo humne yahan pe start kiya tha, जब हमने यहाँ पर हमारा इक्वेशन स्टार्ट किया था तो वी हैड टेकन दिस डेल स्क्वायर एज डेल स्क्वायर बाय एक्स डेल एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल वाई स्क्वायर प्लस डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल जेड स्क्वायर. सो इन दैट वी विल नॉट बी टेकिंग इनटू कंसीडरेशन दिस डेल जेड स्क्वायर. लास्ट वाला टर्म वहां पर नहीं आएगा. वी विल हैव साई ऑफ एक्स वाई ओनली बिकॉज देर आर ओनली टू डायमेंशंस आर देयर. सो इट इज अ प्लेनर सरफेस. प्लेनर सरफेस है तो उसमें से दो एक्सिस ही रहेंगे, दैट इज एक्स एंड वाई एक्सिस. जेड टर्म नहीं आएगा. सो साई ऑफ एक्स वाई विल बी इक्वल टू साई वन ऑफ एक्स इनटू साई टू ऑफ वाई, दैट इज साई वन साई टू, बस इतना ही रहेगा. सो आपका दो ही टर्म्स रहेंगे, डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल एक्स स्क्वायर वाला टर्म और डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल वाई स्क्वायर वाला टर्म. एंड देन यू विल हैव इट 8 पाई स्क्वायर एम ई अपॉन एच स्क्वायर इनटू साई वन साई टू इक्वल्स टू जीरो. तो ये z स्क्वायर वाला जो टर्म है वो कैंसिल हो जाएगा, साइड की टर्म यहाँ से कैंसिल हो जाएगा. इस तरह से आप सेम डेरिवेशन कर सकते हो और आपको दो इक्वेशंस मिलेंगे इंस्टेड ऑफ थ्री. हियर यू विल हैव इट k1 स्क्वायर एंड k2 स्क्वायर ओनली, नॉट द k3 स्क्वायर. तो वहां पर हमारा डेल z स्क्वायर नहीं है, इसलिए k3 स्क्वायर हमारा नहीं आएगा. दो ही इक्वेशंस मिलेंगे. वी विल हैव इक्वेशन नंबर 5 एंड 6 ओनली, not the equation number 7. So you will have it here in equation number 14. You will not have this under root of 2 upon c term. Ye wala term humara nahi rahega, sirf do hi terms rahenge, psi. And so psi will be equal to under root of 4 upon ab. 4 upon ab rahega, that is 2 upon under root ab. 4 is under root 4 is equal to 2. So 2 upon under root AB आएगा, sine into sine of N1 by X upon A into sine of N2 pi by upon A. बस इतना ही रहेगा वहां पे. So their energy will be accordingly being carried out. तो आपका टू डायमेंशन और थ्री डायमेंशन बॉक्स में सिर्फ इतना ही डिफरेंस रहेगा कि हमारा जो सी टर्म है या N3 टर्म है वो नहीं रहेगा यहाँ पर, बाकी सारी चीजें सेम रहेगी. सो वी विल नॉट बी कंसिडरिंग टू डायमेंशनल बॉक्स. यहाँ होमवर्क में कर लो टू डायमेंशनल बॉक्स. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स जस्ट लेट मी नो. व्हेन वी कंसिडर दिस थ्री डायमेंशनल बॉक्स वी हैव डिफरेंट क्वांटम नंबर्स N1 N2 एंड N3. So there can be different levels or values of these quantum numbers. So we can have correspondingly different energy levels will be obtained. Different energy states can be obtained by using different values of these three quantum numbers, N1, N2 and N3. One we have already used it for ground state, that is N1, N2 and N3, all three equal to 1. If you make it just higher than that, by increasing one of the three quantum numbers to 2 and remaining other two as 1, we will get three combinations. Next higher state is 2-1-1, 1-2-1 and 1-1-2. Here first digit is N1, second N2 and third is N3. So we have 2-1-1, 1-2-1 and 1-1-2. So three states we will have it. These three states are having their energies will be E of 2-1-1 will be equal to H square upon 8 MA square into 2 square plus 1 square plus 1 square. That is equal to 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6. So it will be 6x square upon 8 ma square, which will be equal to E of 1-2-1 equals to E of 1-1-2. All three will be having same energy. All three states will be having same energy. Such energy states, such states which are having same energy are called as degenerate states or degenerate energy levels. Degenerate states or degenerate energy levels, and the phenomenon is called as degeneracy. Phenomenon is called as degeneracy. Here in this particular state, we have triply degenerate state. This is a triply degenerate state. That is E211 is a triply degenerate state, because there are three energy levels which are having same energy, or three states which are having same energy. So it will be triply degenerate state, or we call it as degeneracy equals 3. It has a degree of degeneracy is 3. That is, we call it as P is equal to 3. The state or degree of degeneracy, we define it as P, that is called as 3, or P is equal to 3 for this particular state. We can have similarly different states, like we had it ground state, N1, N2 and N3 equals to 1, E of 1-1-1, which was having only one state corresponding to that. No other state, state was having that particular energy. So that we call it as non-degenerate energy level. Non-degenerate energy level. Or we call it as non-degenerate state. And because it is having only one energy corresponding to that state, not more than one state. So we are having that we call it as degree of degeneracy is 1, or a non-degenerate energy levels. Similarly, we can draw it for other energy states also. So now here we can represent the degeneracy over here and here as combination of quantum numbers, and here as the energy state on the y-axis. So first was our E is equal to 3. First was corresponding to E is equal to 3. We had this state where P is equal to 1, that is degeneracy was 1 and combination was 1, 1, 1. Second state we have it as 6, where our degeneracy level P is equal to 3, because there are 3 states corresponding to this. So we have it 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1 and 2, 1, 1. Then we have third corresponding to 9, where also degeneracy level will be equal to 3. Here we will have 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 and 1, 2, 2. You have to see all the permutations and combinations. We will have it 11, then 12, 14, 17, 18, 19, 21, 22, 24, 26, and we will also see of 27. इतने combinations का आप देखो, 12 का तो आपने बताया, that is 222. ये एक ही स्टेट हो सकता है 222 का, दूसरा स्टेट वहाँ पे पॉसिबल नहीं है, सो हमारा यहाँ पे P is equal to 1 होगा. It is a non-degenerate energy level. 11 वाला कौन सा होगा? 113, then 131 and 311. One, three, two, two, one, three, two, three, two, three, one, two, three, two, one. Six combinations. So we'll have P is equal to 6. So degeneracy level is 6 here. It is a 6 level of degeneracy it is having it. This is non-degenerate, triply degenerate, or yahan pe hamara ye 6 level of degeneracy we will have it. 27 is having 333, 3 square plus 3 square plus 3 square, 9 plus 9 plus 9, 27. Then we have 5 ka square 25 hota hai, or 1 plus 1 agar hum karenge to wo bhi 27 hota hai, that is 511. Ye bhi hamara 27 hoga, 5 square 25 plus 1 plus 1, 27. So you will have 151 and 115. So here the degeneracy level will be 4. It is quartet degenerate. So 4 level of degeneracy we will have. So it is not necessarily ki sirf unko jo dikh raha hai ek hi. Yahan pe 2 ka jo hamara tha wo combination ek hi tha. Dusra combination wahan pe possible nahi tha. Lekin dusri jagahon pe wo dusra combination bhi possible ho sakta hai. One thing you have to remember it is कि दो numbers अगर हमारे एक ही हो, जैसे 113, 221 या 112, इसमें दो digits हमारे same है, third one change है, तो ये triply degenerate होता है. अगर तीनों हमारे अलग-अलग numbers हो, तो ये degeneracy होगी, sixth level of degeneracy होगा. अगर तीनों numbers हमारे अलग होंगे, तो it will be sixth degeneracy level. अगर दो सेम रहेंगे एक अलग होगा तो इट विल बी ट्रिपल इंटीग्रल, लेकिन इसके साथ दूसरे कॉम्बिनेशन जो है वो भी आपको देखने हैं, इसके साथ में दूसरे कॉम्बिनेशन भी आपको देखने होते हैं, सो दैट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू लुक इट इन टू। तो बाकी के जो नंबर्स हैं वो आप होमवर्क में कर लो, 17, 18, 19, 21, 22 and 24 and 26 ये आप होमवर्क में कर लो बाकी के, एंड फिल अप दिस पर्टिकुलर चार्ट। सो व्हेन वी हैव अ पर्टिकुलर लेवल ऑफ डीजेनरेसी, दैट इज फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव इट E211 equals E112, ये हमने देखा था कि इन तीनों का एनर्जी इक्वल टू 6h² upon 8ma² इतना आ रहा है। सो यहाँ पे क्या होगा कि ये एनर्जी सेम है बट देयर वेव फंक्शंस विल बी डिफरेंट, बट हैव डिफरेंट वेव फंक्शंस आर प्रेजेंट। Different wave functions where we have it for Psi 211, we will have under root of 8 upon A cube. ये हमारा same रहेगा because ABC हमारा यहाँ पे equals to AAA, so it will be A cube. यहाँ पे हमारा sin of 2 pi x by A because it was n1 pi x by A. So n1 is our 2, n2 is 1 and n3 is 1. So here it will be sin of pi y by b because n1 is 1 and n2 is 1, so that will be coming up as pi y by a. Here it will be pi z by c, or this will all be a. Then we will have it psi of 121 will be equal to under root of 8 upon a cube sin of pi x by a sine of 2 pi y by a into sine of pi z by a. Here 2 is at the center, that is n2 ke liye 2 tha, isliye ye aayega. Then we have it psi 112 equals under root 8 upon a cube sine of pi x by a sin of pi y by a to sin of 2 pi z by a. So ye itna hamara ye hoga. So this way we can write our wave functions also. So exam mein agar aapko aata hai questions, so you will you should be in a position to write this. होमवर्क के लिए आप इनका यू कैन राइट इट एज डिटरमाइन डिग्री ऑफ डीजेनरेसी ऑफ द एनर्जी लेवल्स नंबर वन E is equal to yeah, 19h² upon 8ma² and number 2 E is equal to 26h² upon 8ma². Give here wave function. ये wave functions अगर नहीं भी पूछा जाए then also you have to write the wave function corresponding to your n1, n2 and n3 के जो भी combinations होंगे वो सारों का wave functions आपको देना होगा। जितना भी degree of degeneracy है that you have to find it out and then you have to write the wave function for all the three. तो ट्रिपल डीजेनरेट जो लेवल होता है दैट वी आल्सो कॉल इट एज थ्री फोल्ड डिग्री ऑफ डीजेनरेसी, अगर सिक्स डिग्री ऑफ डीजेनरेसी है तो वी कॉल इट एज सिक्स फोल्ड ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ डीजेनरेसी। सो सिमिलरली वी कैन हैव इट डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशन एंड फाइंड इट आउट फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर energy levels.